Would you like to use a separate file to study QuickBooks Online as an attorney so you don't affect your actual law firm's records? Well, then you should watch this video, Signing Up for QuickBooks Online. I will do my best to try to get you the software for free. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. In order to make the learning of this course go more smoothly, you should keep a separate account for the transactions that you record when following this course step by step. You should not mix the transactions that you see in this course with your actual law firm financial records. And I will try my very best to get you that separate account for free. This video is all about signing up for your QuickBooks Online account. Please note, however, the rest of the video is the sign-up video from the QuickBooks Online crash course because I think it's a perfect demonstration of how to sign up for the Plus version of QuickBooks Online for free. The setup and sign-up steps are exactly the same as if you're signing up for a law firm. Just follow exactly what you see in the rest of the video. If you follow step by step, you should be finished with a 30-day trial version of the Plus version of QuickBooks Online, which is the minimum necessary for attorneys. Now, the video that follows this one will show you how to join using the Accountant's Edition, which is currently free, but I don't know how long the Accountant's Edition will be free for anyone who signs up. And the menu choices in the Accountant's Edition are very, very similar, so you should still be able to follow step by step. After you're done signing up, the video that follows that one will show you how to start customizing the file for attorneys in a law firm. So enjoy the rest of the video. I know you'll easily sign up with a 30-day free trial if that's what you choose to follow along in the course. And I thank you, and I will see you in the next video. Preparing your QuickBooks Online account. Most software courses require that you purchase the software in order to follow along. That's if you choose to learn by repeating what you see step by step. I will try to help you get the software for free. I cannot promise that you will have a free account. The free versions are only available in the United States. If you cannot get one free, then you must purchase the QuickBooks Online software if you choose to follow along step by step. You need a separate QuickBooks Online account for this course. You should not enter the transactions that you see in this course into your actual QuickBooks Online company file. So this will be a demonstration of exactly how to sign up. You can get the Plus version for 30 days free. This is what we will be using in the course and what will be shown here in this demonstration of how to sign up. You could instead watch the following video that will show you how to sign up for free for the Accountant's Edition. The Accountant's Edition is free indefinitely and looks similar enough for you to use for this course. So, you must sign up by using an email address that has never been used before with a QuickBooks Online account. The website address to sign up will always change, so you have to be patient and flexible. If the web address is different from what you see here because you are watching this video after they changed it, well then don't worry. The new address to sign up will be in the description text of the page of this video. They may have even changed the exact steps or changed the interface that you see. This will happen all the time when you use QuickBooks Online. Just use your best judgment to try to activate the fewest features possible so we can go faster with the rest of the setup. On the day that I am making this video, this is the website address to sign up for the free 30-day trial version. Don't forget to save your username and password. I suggest that you prepare them in a text document and then keep them separate from the login information for your real QuickBooks Online company account. So, I come here and I paste. This is exactly the web address. Hit enter, and you will come to this page. Now, in order to get the three free 30-day trial version, you know, a lot of stuff pops up, this center button will give you the ability to do that. Because if you select any of these right now, QuickBooks Online will assume you're ready to buy. But if you click this button for free 30-day trial, then after you click for the free 30-day trial, they'll ask you about payroll, or at least lately they will, and you don't want any payroll there. So we just click select for the plus version. Actually, now they're asking you if you want to add payroll, and we will click continue without payroll. So it explains a little bit about the plan under the assumption that you will buy it after 30 days. And then you click checkout. So now we're ready to sign up, and I have my username as the email address that will be associated with the account. And of course, mobile number. And my password I already made in advance, a password that I know satisfies the conditions that they're asking for. Now that we have everything, we click sign up with email and give it a moment. Now, remember, they think you're trying to buy the software. Be very careful. Click continue with trial. Now, they're going to ask us a few basic questions, but we're just going to put in the minimum amount to be able to get right into the account to start working. So this is Vonda Video. And spelling doesn't count. How would you describe what your business does? In a real situation, you would type in whatever's necessary, but you do not check the box that we're transferring over from desktop. Click Next. Now, we might want to do these things, but not during the crash course. During the crash course, we select as little as possible so we can get directly into the software to start working. So don't click on any of these. Click Next. Now, we do not have employees. So click No and click Next. Now, the quickest and easiest way to manage this is to click that you're the owner. This way, you're the main administrator and you can simply use all the tools without a problem. So double click Owner. Now, do you have an accountant or a bookkeeper? In our course, we click No, I do it all myself. Then click Next. Now, we don't want to use bank feeds at the beginning. You will learn a little bit about bank feeds later on, but the proper way to learn at the beginning is to manually add transactions. Now we click All Set, and we could take a quick tour later. I'm going to close this out, and you're welcome to pause the video and take a quick tour. But basically, this is the QuickBooks Online interface. This is what it looks like when you first sign in. You're at the dashboard, and everything else is using one of the menu choices that you will learn about to navigate. And there are really only three main areas that you have to concern yourself with. The plus sign on the left that says new, the cogwheel on the top right for long-term information, and this left panel of menu choices here. Now here's a little advice before navigating around the software. QuickBooks Online changes the position of features all the time. Cloud-based software can have the features moved to a different place to click in order to open the feature. This often surprises and even frustrates the QuickBooks Online users. Have faith. The feature you're looking for or are learning is definitely there. Just patiently try clicking the options you see, and you will soon find the place to open the window that you need. They may just be waiting for me to make a video that shows the feature so that they can change the place you click to open it up. And sometimes I feel that way, but if you see small differences, be aware that the reason I did not remake the video is because after I remake the video, they might move the item back to its original place, and that's happened before. So here's how you navigate around QuickBooks Online. Never lost in QuickBooks Online. There is more than one way to open most windows, but for some things, there's only one way to open the windows you need. There are three main menu sets in the QuickBooks Online interface. First, there's the cogwheel in the top right, and the cogwheel is for menu choices that you would click on for things like setup windows, tools that you will use, and general administration. The most important main menu is the new transaction main menu in the top left, right by the plus sign. These are for every possible transaction that you could possibly have in QuickBooks Online. And then, of course, there's the third main menu, the left panel. Now, the items listed in the left panel are simply repeats of the same windows that you could open from either the cogwheel or the new transaction window when you click the plus sign. But some of these things you can only open from the left panel. For example, the only place that you can open up QuickBooks reports is the report tab in the left panel. And that's the most important menu choice because it will be the custom reports that will allow us to easily navigate through QuickBooks Online during this course. Then, of course, there's the sales tab for customer data and customer data management. So if you want to add a customer, remove a customer, or change the customer's permanent or setup information, the only place that you can do that is by clicking the sales tab in the left panel. Before we move to the next video, let's see some live action with the interface. When we click the cog, you can see that all of these relate to permanent information or tools or any kind of thing that relates to setting up QuickBooks Online, as well as using tools to manage your QuickBooks Online. But on the top left, you have the plus sign next to the word new. That's the main menu that you would click on if you want to record any type of transaction in QuickBooks Online. And then, of course, we have the left panel here. Now, of course, some of these things you will find are just repeats, but the most important item on the left panel is the reports. because we're going to navigate through QuickBooks Online using the custom reports that we will set up very soon.